Hello, and welcome to Agarthism Explained. In this video, I will be explaining and revisiting Zero, the King of Agartha. On June 24th, around 3.5 billion years ago in the present-day Eastern Mediterranean Sea, Zero Infinite was created by the result of the evolutionary split. His female counterpart is Cyprus Infinite. Zero would evolve from a single-celled organism into a human and would first touch land in the present-day Gaza Strip. His name refers to his need to establish balance in his home dimension of Agartha. His destiny is to kill order and chaos, as both are slowly destroying Agartha. Zero is eternal, however, he can still die. When he does though, he enters the void surrounded by reflections of his past. Zero can go to any event in his life by entering the reflection, creating a new dimension each time, although he rarely does. Zero and Cyprus's creations established kingdoms across Earth. The gods in those kingdoms would turn on him and Cyprus, leading to them both having hatred for them all. In Dimension 21, Zero kills a large portion of gods in the kingdoms, including Zeus and Athena. Before Zero finally kills him, Zeus sends a message to Chaos to bring her wrath upon Agartha. Zero is altered by Athena and Pandora, therefore, his angel to balance his demon Fear is created and named Hope. Fear is Zero's inner demon, and before the Great War, he was only a part of Zero's mind and soul. Fear would only take over when Zero was in a position where any mortal's life would be threatened. When the Great War was in its early days, the Shadow Man manipulated Zero to stare at his reflection in the fire. This brought Fear to life. Fear would haunt Zero from then on. Fear invades Agartha during Revelations, which brings demons and mortals from many dimensions causing chaos. On June 18, 2068, the final battle occurs between Zero and Fear. The battle lasts until the 21st when Zero rips Fear's head off but has his own heart torn out. Just before Zero dies, Chaos intervenes and restarts time back to the beginning of the invasion. After receiving the message sent by Zeus thousands of years ago, she resurrects every dead god, including the ones killed by Zero. Cyprus returns to Agartha to help Zero battle Chaos. Zero gets many allies to ally with him and Cyprus against Chaos. After Zero defeated and killed Chaos, he used his new powers to remake and restore Agartha. He then founded Agartha City, a city that expanded across the entire island of Cyprus. Every mortal and every god got to live free in a utopia with new freedom and another chance at life. The brother of Chaos, Order, became rogue and started to corrupt Agartha City. After 2 years of conflict, in 2070, Order was killed by Zero. In 210 BC, Zero made a year-long journey from Egypt to the Eastern Eurasian steppes to look for possible Greek expansionism into the region. There, he met Modin Chenyu. They got along well, and Zero started to use the term Mongolian to describe the people that resided in the area. Modin Chenyu, in a family succession battle, ordered his men to kill his father Tumen. Zero helped in this and killed Tumen, making the new unified Xiongnu Empire an ally to the Greeks against the Qin and future Han Dynasty of China. Zero was to focus in the west with the Roman advance in Britain to defend the Xiongnu from the Xian Bay. Zero came back to the area in 330 AD and helped the Xiongnu's ancestors to overthrow the Xian Bay and form the new Rurin Khaganate. With the Turks on their rise to power, they took over the Khaganate and formed a Turkish one. This was the start to Zero's hatred for the Turks. As they took over the Eurasian steppes, for once in history, he even tried to help the Persians repel their advance into the Sassanid Empire, but was rejected. The region of Mongolia became embodied with war and conquest. It turned from a region of great interest for Zero to an enemy. He aided the Chinese Tang dynasty in wars with the Turkish and Uyghur Khaganates. The Mongols then created their new empire in 1206 with Genghis Khan as their leader. Zero saw the potential to destroy the Chinese, Persian, and Turkish states. He allied with Genghis Khan and together over the next 20 years. They conquered the Eurasian steppes as brothers. In August 1227, Zero and Genghis rode together when Genghis fell off and sustained serious injuries. Zero tried his best to bring him back to Agartha, but it was too late. After his death, the empire split and Zero lost hope with the region, seeing the Mongols' future as being nothing like it ever was. Before the Agarthalypse, Zero created Alpha Sigma, a pack and family of wolves destined to reunite to achieve an eternal joy. He found all of his friends in Alpha Sigma, then traveled to Agartha to attempt to rebuild his home. Unfortunately, unlike after the Chaos War, the world could not be civilized. During the Agarthalypse, he was the sole leader of humanity. Him and Sigma created the Alpha Sigma Brotherhood, but found out he had something to do with Iota's disappearance. Eventually, Zero reunited 24 of the Alpha Sigma members, and together liberated the world from the undead. After the Agarthalypse came the Agarthago, where all life became intelligent and formed alliances. Zero mainly sided with the apes and won war after war. When humanity was restored to their original position, Zero became cold. This was apparent during the Dimensional Wars, where the humans from the Dark Aether invaded Agartha. He saw them as an inferior race to the Agarthans. Lambda also manipulated Zero during the Agarthago, replacing his ex, Gamma, but eventually restored their love when she found him in Greece at the beginning of the Agarthessene. During the Agarthessene, he and Alpha Sigma were tasked to destroy the despotic group of Hong Kong while fighting there. Alpha Sigma began to fall apart. One by one, each member died. Beta by Z, Delta and Epsilon by Gamma, Eta by Zeta. Zeta by himself, Iota, Epsilon, Omicron, and Omega by Sigma, and Lambda and Sigma by Zero. After Gamma's death, Cyprus left Agartha fearing it would be destroyed after the defeat of the DGHK, leading to no balance. At the start of the Agarthacon, Zero and the Greek Primordial Phanes resurrected all Alpha Sigma members. Zero left Agartha to go search for Cyprus in Dimension 65-1 and get answers. He found out that the Norse god, Tyr, traveled there and allied with Cyprus. Zero left for Midgard and found Tyr, who tells Zero that Cyprus is in the realm of Greece after the god suddenly disappeared. Zero traveled to Olympus and finds out the world has been eaten by a great flood. He travels through a portal and awakens to find himself in a war-torn Farron in Dimension 24-1. He sees the war is being fought by the natives, wizards, dwarves, and Faerunian gods against the Greek gods. He finds Cyprus and reunites with no other than Athena herself, which is his first time seeing her since her death during the Third Great War. They ask him to fight in the war, but after Cyprus tells him that Ares and Poseidon are in Agartha, he hurries back home. After realizing Ares and Poseidon had already left to Dimension 24-1, Zero found Eta, Kappa, Theta, Z, Mu, and Taff at the observatory trying to get there as well. Zero travels with them to Dimension 24-1 and links back up with Cyprus and Athena. Cyprus, Athena, Eta, Kappa, and Z find Ares, Rho, Lambda, Sigma, and Omega, and takes them back to Zero and the others. Zero found the other members including Chi, Nu, Omicron, Phi, Pi, C, Epsilon, as well as Poseidon. The Faerunian War was swiftly won by the pro-Greek forces and resulted in the Greek gods and the rest of their mortals colonizing the continent. Zero tries to return to Agartha but is sent to Hell. After hearing news of Alpha Sigma Athens and Thessaloniki's abduction, he meets Morningstar, a bastard child of Lucifer who wants to overthrow her father. Her resemblance to Alpha Sigma Oscar persuades Zero to help her cause. He also meets Dark Angel, who helps Zero find Rachel Amber, the Seven Sins, and the Emerald Angels. After being unable to make a deal with Lucifer, Zero, Morningstar, Dark Angel, and the first generation of Alpha Sigma go to Fear's Forest in Hell to fight the final battle against Lucifer's legions of hundreds of thousands of demons. Before the fight ensues, Fear finds Zero. Being the first time that they have seen each other since the Third Great War, Am joins his army. They have trouble at the start, however, on Fear's bridge. Fear gives Zero his consent to kill him to absorb his power with the Infinite Dagger. Zero accepts and kills him, absorbing Fear's soul, and afterwards wins the battle. He makes all of the first generation members of Alpha Sigma gods. Then, because of Fear's corruption, sets on a mission to liberate the world of Chaosticism in what he calls an Agarthan Crusade. Zero started going crazy and heard the voices of Fear and Hope. In order to resolve the corruption, Morningstar crafted the Agarthan Mist, a device made from the mist of the Grey Sun that Zero calls medicine. One day, after consuming this medicine, he falls into a 65-year coma. During this time, the economy of Agartha has crashed and the Agarthan forces have lost the war to the Chaostics. Zero also has a vision in his dreams of him being resurrected by the Agarthan frogs. He wakes up 3 days later, after being visited by Elizabeth Comstock to see all of this, and decided it was time for a change, beginning the Agarthian. Zero also changes his name to feel more like a mortal and cover his past. His new name is Matthew Narvazilos, being the protagonist of Agartha. He has plenty of more stories to be shared, but for now, this was a summary of Zero Infinite, the King of Agartha. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Thank you for watching. This has been Agarthism Explained. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.